say that I need to be safe.
But that's just like you, a rainbow.
Say with me, the devil got his way.
You think I'm like a rainbow? Do you like Patrick?
How you think you know it?
You'll never be Jewish.
Hello, welcome back to the Shtick. We've just seen the trailer for Hannah Rosenthal, which is a film which Naomi Lisner was involved with. Tell me your involvement with that film.
Well, I guess I'm involved in it largely.
Up to your neck, right at the top of your head.
Well, I wrote it. It was the first time I've directed anything.
Yeah.
And I play Hannah. So
it's all about disability in a way,
well,
isn't it?
Well, yes. I wanted to write a different story.
And attitudes.
Well, yeah, Hannah is intellectually challenged and she's living with her mother, Miriam, who is, you know, a traditional Jewish woman. Mm. And Hannah works as a life model, which, you know, probably not a traditional Jewish thing that you do.
Really?
Her father was a photographer and she always, you know, was around the models. So, you know, and it's a way that she can earn money and be independent. And one day when she's modeling, she meets this brilliant artist, Patrick.
Played by
Derek, who is...
Derek again!
Yeah, who is intellectually challenged, but again, an incredible artist, because I want to show that people with disabilities can be independent and, you know, quite capable of doing everything. And someone said to me, why didn't you use, you know, a disabled actor? And for me, it's not about that. It's Daniel Day-Lewis, you know, how brilliant was he in My Left Foot? I think that we get to a stage that we're too politically correct. And I think, you know, audition everyone, but choose who you think that you want for that role. And
because that's what acting is all about.
Because that's what acting is about. That's the meaning of being an actor. Yeah, I know. I think sometimes that gets lost in political correctness.
Keep me out of it.
Oh, I know. Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, I wrote that and it's lucky. I have a great team around me. Lorraine Fabb played my mother and she was brilliant. Mm. And she, incidentally, is Jewish. So.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Never know.
You wouldn't know. She's a talented woman. She's a brilliant ballroom dancer. So incredible cast. And yeah, and it's traveled all over the world, except for Australia, funnily enough. But it's been really everywhere. And I've been humbled and surprised and amazed and
so
loving.
So what have you been nominated for with Hannah Rose?
Oh, okay. It won the Honolulu Golden Kahuna Award for Best Film. It won Best Australian Film in the Malta Film Festival. It's won in Israel. It's won in LA.
Can anyone see it here? That's what I want to know.
Not yet. But it got international distribution.
Right.
So it's going all
over. It's going everywhere except here. It's not coming here last.
Well, I don't know. I don't know. For some reason, the festivals didn't, you know, haven't accepted. I don't know if it's because it's the topic.
It's too Jewish.
I don't. Well, I can't help that. But hopefully we'll get embraced with L'Chaim in Australia. But that's now starting.
That's the other one now. I wanted to discuss L'Chaim with you. Now, what's that about?
Well, funnily enough, I started writing that on the plane back from Spain when Hannah won a special award in Spain. And as I was, you know, as I was sitting in the plane, because let's face it, the plane trip is 25 hours, and so you have to do something. So I started, the idea was forming in my head then, and it's set in World War too, and it was the second time that I directed. Again, a great team of actors and, you know, and crew around me. Mm. And she's a starving Jew in the forest, and clearly I look like I'm a starving Jew. Yeah. And she sees a farmer beating his son, and knowing that, you know, if she goes to help him, she's putting her life at risk, but she
does
helps
it anyway.
Him anyway. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And so, yeah, it's a film based around that I'm actually even considering turning into a feature. I don't know.
How long is L'Chaim?
Oh, you know, they're both short films. Hannah is now edited down to 15 minutes. L'Chaim is just over 8 minutes.
Right.
But again, there's so much that I want to do with so many of my projects, and particularly, you know, the imbalance, the comedy that I wrote. I wrote a sequel after that.
Mm-hmm. Which was?
With the imbalance too.
But the imbalance I'm not, too.
In imbalance too, because there was so much
well,
to write.
Well, you had to balance them.
Touché.
Yeah.
But I'm actually would like to make it into a TV series. So.
Right, that's the potential.
I really think that it would make a great series.
Yeah.
I've got a friend who I was in a feature with, back in the 80s. And so he's going there for me. He's, you know,
what's his name?
His name's Adrian Bonatti. He lives in Palm Springs. Fantastic friend. We did a film in 1983. And it was produced by David Joseph, who was producer on the pirate film, but he also used to manage David Bowie and Manfred Mann. And that's the fantastic thing about the film industry. You make lifelong friends, and when you go to film festivals, I've got friends from all over the world, and, you know, the directors of some of these film festivals are so passionate that and they love what they're doing, that it's just such a, you know, honor to be invited.
Well, it's been an honor to have you in the studio. We've finally reached the end of our time. From one segment to two to three, Naomi Lisner, we love your shtick. We'll be back next week with more shtick. We'll be right back.